touch, two, one, touchdown.
He has the million-dollar view and the confidence of a fighter pilot.
We're pretty confident as tower operators, but we can't let that go to our heads.
The tonnage of materials he flies with his tower crane is only equaled by the weight he carries on his shoulders.
Anybody that can take the responsibility into their hands to operate a crane is a different breed.
Trini Smith has operated cranes for more than 20 years.
They just said, hey, you have an aptitude for it.
He now works on the Salt Lake Temple renovation project, the apex of his career.
It's not just going up there and running a crane, it's about the experience of running the crane on a project of this magnitude and its historical value.
Trini's day starts around 6 a.m.
Do those time slots work for everybody?
In a coordination meeting with all the subcontractors on site to ensure their hauling needs are met.
Crane coordination is a critical element to make the project run smoothly. Every delivery that we bring has got to be scheduled, gets on the hook with the scheduled crane time.
Brad Bonney says cranes and their crews are the lifeblood of the Salt Lake Temple construction site.
We couldn't do it without cranes.
Crucial for a site that spans a single city block with limited access.
Any other conflicts that we need to resolve? Looks like we're pretty clean on the South Tower crane.
After meeting with the subcontractors, Trini's crew updates their daily schedule. Then it's time to make the 20-minute climb to the top of the 270-foot tower crane. These solitary surroundings aren't for everyone. He won't climb down again until the job board is cleared for the day, which often surpasses 8 hours. He does everything at these lofty heights, from taking his lunch break to, well, everything else. These controls become extensions of Trini's own hands that operate with the precision and skill of a surgeon.
The machine is a part of your body, basically.
The payload weight, wind, and sway of the crane are constantly calculated to fly and land load safely and accurately.
Every pick, every movement you make, you're constantly taking safety into consideration.
But crane operators like Trini have a secret weapon that aids in their excellence and a must when it comes to safety.
All right, Trini, coming up easy.
Skilled riggers that know how to tie a load safely and efficiently.
Just gotta check everything real quick.
Riggers have a special bond forged in trust with the guy in the sky.
One, hands on. They're guys that we trust our lives with because we're under those hooks. So that kind of tells you what I think of operators. They are just, they're the best in their field.
A bond that goes both ways. On the ground, riggers are the eyes, ears, and voice of caution for the crane operator.
We go through a lot to make sure everything we put in the air is safe. We do a lot of inspections with our rope, our rigging. Every time we put a hook to a pick point, we check for fractures, cracks, make sure the areas are cleared when we fly things overhead.
Communication is key.
All right, you're touching down on one side, inches for the other, and you are down.
Radio is a prominent communication, but if radio communication isn't available, you go to hand signals.
Whatever the job, there's a strap.
That's 3-inch.
Chain, choker, or hook. A tool chest of solutions for any payload to ensure it flies safely and securely over a construction site teeming with workers.
Let's take 420s and see how the angle looks.
Riggers are laser focused as they prepare this platform for flight over the construction site.
I'd like to do it before the wind picks up.
It needs to fly before the weather changes. The 10,000 pound platform heads to the top of the temple roof for installation. Besides the heavy lifting of scaffolding, temple stones, and steel, these cranes perform often unnoticed but critical job site tasks such as trash removal and maintenance. By the time the temple renovation project is complete, they will have moved more than an estimated 40 million pounds of material, equal to 2 times the weight of the Eiffel Tower.
The church has always been special to me, and I'm getting a little choked up right now. The opportunity to work on such a project, especially this temple, it's really, really special.
Like a conductor performing a symphony, Trini, with the help of his crew, will be at the controls affecting virtually every job on site through his extended touch.
It's an important piece of this project. So going home at night and knowing that and saying, yeah, this couldn't have proceeded without my hands, the work that I put into it. Yeah, that's rewarding.